structure of relational database. You can follow me in my Telegram link t.me/bhargavics, and you can follow my YouTube channel for my notes and for my classes. Right now, before going to the enter into the subject, first we need to know what is mean by database. Database is nothing but a collection of data which is in a organizational way. Okay, now in RDBMS, that means Relational Database Management System. So till now we learned only one term, that is DBMS, Database Management System. So these database management systems have different types: object-oriented, network, hierarchical, distributed. Like RDBMS, we have different kinds of database. Mostly everybody uses in a organizations RDBMS. Why? Because RDBMS is nothing but Relational Database Management System. In this, the data is represented in the form of the relations. So it is easy to understand, easy to implement. So everybody uses the relational databases according to their requirement of their organization. Clear? So in the database system, in the relational database management system, the data is represented in the form of the relations. Relation is nothing but a table. Clear? Now we'll see how the structure of the relational databases. Structure is nothing but what? How it will be built? What are the contents into that? We'll see one by one. Now, structure of the relational database. Relational is nothing but in the form of a tables, right? So the data is represented in the form of the relations. Relations also called as tables. Now we see how the structure is going to design for this relational database. Now, structure of the relational database. A relational database consists of collection of tables, each having unique name. That means what? Relational database contains collection of tables. So again, go for the same example of the hospital. So what tables we have? We have patient table, right? We have doctor's table. We have administration table. We have management table. So all together tables have different names. That means unique name should be there for each and every table so that they should not get confused in the database. So all together is what? All together is called as a hospital database. So a row in a table represents the relationship among a set of values. Thus a table represents a collection of the relationships. Now we'll come to know with the diagram what is row, what is column, what is a relationship. There is a direct correspondence between the concept of a table and mathematical concept of a relation. So what we have, the table. Table is nothing but it consists of set of rows and columns, right? Set of rows and columns. Now why you are calling this table as a relation? Why you are calling this table as a relation means we have a correspondence relation between the concept of a table and mathematical relation. So in your SSE, you have sets and relations. Yes or no? So whatever the operations you are performing on the relations, the same operations you can perform over the table also. So here in the RDBMS, we are calling the table as a relation. Clear? A substantial theory has been developed for the relational databases based on the mathematical relation. So we are calling the table as a relation. Next we have relational model. So relational database, relational model, everything is same. Some terminologies are different into that. So we'll see one by one. So relational model represents the database is a collection of relations. A relation is nothing but table of values. Table, relation, both are same. Every row in the table represents a collection of related data values. These rows are in the table denote a real world entity or a relationship. For example, here we have a table of student. Consider here we have a table of student. So in this student table, what columns we have? We have student ID, student name, student say age, right? So what the names are there? Number one, name of the student is A, and the age of the student is considered say 10 years, right? So what this row is representing? This row is representing a relation of the student. That means every row in the table represents collection of related data values. These rows in the table denote a real world entity or a relationship. So these are what? So number two student is there, B student is there, 20 age is there. So these rows are related to which table? These rows are related to student table. Student table is a real world entity. So what is mean by entity? We'll come to the in a ER model, right? So this is a relational model. Next we'll come to know what is mean by ER model. There we'll have an idea that what is entity. The table name and column names are helpful to interpret the meaning of the values in each row. So what is the table name? The table name is here, we are writing as student is our table name. So what are the column names? ID, name of the student, age of the student is what? Column names. So what the column names representing? For example, if I'm not writing the column name here. So by seeing this 10, 20, 30, 25, 15, 16, what do you understand? Are you understand anything? Is it age or is it marks or is it any something, etc., average? So we doesn't get any meaning if you are not writing a column name. So table name and column names are helpful to get the meaning of each row value in that. The data represented as a set of relations. In the relational model, data are stored as the tables. Everywhere, every sentence is same. Data are stored as a table. So these tables are called as relations. However, physical storage of data is independent of way the data are logically organized. Now, logically means what? According to our view, the data is we are storing in the form of a table. But in a physical way, in a file organization manner, the data will be stored in the files. It may be dependent on the DBMS which you are choosing. So that means if you are using RDBMS, data also in the physical model stores in the tables only. If you are using object-oriented model, in the physical data, objects format lo store outundi. Clear? So according to the way of DBMS you choose, the data will be stored on the physical memory. Clear? But in a logical memory, everywhere the data is represented in the form of a tables only. Clear? So logically organization is different, physically organization is different. Logically organization is compulsory tables, whereas physical storage is nothing but it depends upon the chosen DBMS. You may choose object-oriented DBMS, you may choose relational DBMS, network DBMS, hierarchical DBMS. Based on chosen network, based on chosen data type, the physical storage is different compared to your logical storage. So in logical storage, the data is stored in the form of the tables called as relations. Now we see some of the concepts which are related to relational model. So what are the attributes? So just remember all these terms. So these all terms are going to cover your entire syllabus. Clear? So first one is attribute, right? So attribute, nothing but each column in a table, we call it as a attribute. So normally we say table, rows and columns. But according to the relational model terminology, columns are represented as a attribute. Attributes are the properties which are defined a relation. Example, student roll number, name, etc. are called as attributes. Clear? Tables. Next we have table. In a relational model, the relations are saved in the table format. It is stored along with its entities. So what is mean by entity? We'll come to know. Entity is nothing but also a table. A table has two properties, that is rows and columns. So rows represents the records, columns represents the attribute. Clear? Next we have tuple. So tuple is nothing but what? A single row of a table is called as a tuple, which contains a single record. Consider a student table. Now considering here student table, what is this? This table is also called as a relation. So what is this table name? This table name is called, I'm giving a name as customer table, right? So I'm giving the table name as customer. Now this customer ID, customer name, status are what? Column names. So, but in the form of the RDBMS, we call it as those as attributes. Clear? So see here, column or attribute. So what are these? These are columns or attributes. Now, this is one row. This is one row. This is one row. How many rows we have? Three rows we have. But in the terminology of RDBMS, instead of calling row, we call it as a tuple. Clear? Tuple is nothing but a row. So individual thing is called as tuple. Not all the records, only single record is called as the tuple. Clear? Next we see relational schema. So relational schema represents the name of the relation with its attributes. So in the starting classes, we have discussed about the schema. Schema is nothing but what? Just a graphical representation of a table with its attributes. In the next concept also, we are going to see that. Next concept we have degree. So degree is nothing but total number of attributes which in the relation is called as degree of the relation. That means how many number of attributes. Attribute is nothing but what? Columns we have, that is the degree of the table. So in this, how many columns we have? How many attributes we have? 1, 2, 3. So what is the degree? Total number of columns is called as degree. So what is the degree of this? 3 columns we have here. So that is the degree of the table, degree of the relation. Next we have cardinality. So cardinality is nothing but total number of rows present in the table. Degree is nothing but total number of columns. Whereas cardinality is nothing but what? Number of rows. So how many rows we have in this table? 1, 2, 3. So how many tuples we have? Total number of rows is called as the cardinality, that is 3. Clear? Next we have column. The column represents the set of specific attributes. What is a column? Column is nothing, represents a set of values for a specific attribute. Okay, relational instance. So relational instance is a finite set of, where this finite set of tuples in the RDBMS system. Relational instance never have duplicate tuples. So instance is nothing but what? In the first also we have discussed instance. Nothing but what? How much amount of data is presented at a certain amount of time in a database is called as a relational instance. Now here, at a particular moment of this, how much amount of data we have, that we call it as a relational instance. So how many records we have? 3 records we have. So the relation instance is what? 3. Next we have relational key. So this keys plays the main important role throughout your syllabus, and those are much more important for your academic as well as for whenever you go for any interviews. These rows and these relation keys are very much important. The next topic, that means next session, is on the keys only. Now every row has 1 or 2 or multiple attributes, which is called a relational key. Clear? So what is mean by key? We'll come to the in the next session. Next, attribute domain. So every attribute has some predefined values and scope, which is known as attribute domain. So attribute domain is nothing but, for example, I want to define a predefined values for a particular attribute. For example, if a student is writing exam, just he attempted. So when a student attempted, but he is not writing any content into the paper, so what we make? We make the exam marks as 0. So if the student is not attempting the exam, so what we write? We write absent, right? So that means if a student is absent, I should get absent there. If his student get the less marks compared to the passing marks, I should get there 0. So what we are doing? We are giving a predefined value to the marks column, so that we can achieve that with the help of the attribute domain. Now look here. So here we have a primary key. This domain is what? Not null. For example, a student is there, but he is not giving his name. So what is the domain? Write the not null. Not null means it should not have a null value. Every attribute, every column of value should have a name. Otherwise, you will not enter the record into the table. Clear? Now, what is this primary key? Primary key is nothing but, so this primary key will be have the unique values in the complete attribute row, attribute column. That means in this column, all the values must and should be of unique. So that means 1, 2, 3. For example, if I have again 1, what will happen? If the two customers having the same ID, so it may be problem. For example, if the students got same hall ticket number, what will happen? So which exam, which marks will be given to which students? We don't know. So what we'll make? We'll make the hall ticket number column as the primary key. So that in that all the values should be unique. No other values to be repeated over there. So what is primary key? What is candidate key? What is the super key? We'll come to know in the next class. Clear? So this is a relational table structure.